Minister Information and Broadcasting and Senior Congress Leader Manish Tiwari taking on Seshadri Chari, Member of the National Executive and the Convener of the Foreign Affairs Cell of the BJP, and Times Now's Maruf Raza joining us from Delhi as well. Maruf, good evening. Manish Tiwari, thanks for joining us. Good to see you on NewsHour after a long time. My first question is to Seshadri Chari. I mean, strange situation that you are in. An embarrassing situation that you are in. You go hammer and tongs and insinuate that the Congress wants to defend something suspicious in the Henderson Brooks Bhagwat report on the 1962 war, and that's why this was not made public. Now, your present Defence Minister Arun Jaitley says exactly what he used to criticize the Congress leaders for saying. I mean, I won't even ask you today what your explanation is, but what is your excuse? What is your excuse, Mr. Chari, for doing what you're doing now, for this U-turn?
No, I don't think you are using the correct word if you say excuse. Explanation would be a better terminology. I'll tell you why. It is not Arun Jaitley who says this. We should look at it as the Defence Minister of India who has said it. And the Defence Minister of India said the same thing in the UPA government also.
So which there you is criticized. A reason. Which
yes,
you criticized.
We did criticize at that time. We wanted the defense minister to come clean on it. And the defense minister explained that there are certain things in this report which he was privy to. We did not ask him, why is it that you are, what are you covering up? He said there are certain things that this
but
report cannot be made.
Then. Yes. But you criticized them when they
we
said
did.
That. When they
we
said
did.
That, do you accept or not that the BJP was at the forefront of demanding the full disclosure of the Henderson
yes.
Brooks report that looked into the 1962
exactly.
war? You made the issue political.
In the run-up to the election, you made the issue political. Let me tell you. There were a number of people in our party also at that time who said it should be made. But I'm not going to pat myself on my own back. But I was one person who even tweeted that this report need not be made public now. And I had even said it in your program,
sir,
that don't make it an issue of discussion.
Sir,
at
it
this
was
stage.
Made. Sir, we it was
but it
made.
Was made.
It was
yes,
made
it
an
was
issue
made.
By your party.
And
the, no,
then,
was it made a political issue by your party?
No, we did not make
the
it
problem,
a political issue.
The problem with
we
the
wanted
BJP.
To know what is it that you are covering
sir,
up.
The problem
the
with
defense
the
defense minister came up and said that we can't even say what we are covering up. We are privy. The defense minister
sir,
was privy to something.
Sir, the problem is.
And today the defense minister is privy to the same thing. To which the earlier defense minister was privy to. And I think if
then,
this
then,
defense
then
minister
has the
says,
present defense minister as the should
yes.
the present defense minister say that okay. I came to conclusions at that point of time talking about whether the Himalayan blunder of 1962 was a Nehruvian blunder, that I came to those conclusions on the basis of incomplete facts, and hence the BJP, because Ravi Shankar Prasad said we lost the war because of Nehru, he went on to say what are they trying to hide by making the war report classified. You made all those issues on an issue of immense strategic importance to the country. You milked it politically,
there is,
sir.
There is no difference
of opinion.
You milked
it politically.
There is no difference of opinion as far as the
sir,
role played by the Prime Minister at that time is concerned. That
sir,
entire report and entire documents pertaining to that aspect is
sir,
in the public domain in any case.
Sir, if I may say
it
so.
It is there in the public domain in any
if
case.
If I may be permitted
but,
an observation
but,
here,
but that
it
is
appears
only one
to me.
Part. That is
sir,
only
it
one part
to
of
me
the
that there are two BJPs.
But that is only one part of
sir,
the report. That is only one part of the report.
Doesn't matter.
That report is out in the public domain.
Sir, you
but to put the entire report on the public domain at this stage may not be in the national interest, and that is what the then defense minister felt, and
which,
that is what the present defense minister
which you
feels.
Ridiculed him for. You made jokes about Antony.
Yes.
You raised questions about the Congress party's loyalty.
We did.
You raised the question of motive.
Exactly.
Today people will question your motive. It
so
appears
therefore,
to me
therefore,
today
therefore,
that there
you
are two BJPs.
The
there is one BJP before the election. There is one BJP
no,
after the election.
No, it is not. It is not. The BJP is the same. The defense ministers have changed. That defense minister came to a particular conclusion. This defense minister has also come to the
Manish Tiwari, you're hearing this. Of
I
course,
can,
I mean,
you,
may, you may choose to, you may, no, no, you may choose to pull your punches today. Because obviously you know that my follow-up question will be, what stopped Indira Gandhi from releasing the report? What stopped Rajiv Gandhi from releasing the report? What stopped P.V. Narasimha Rao from releasing the report? right? What stopped Dr. Manmohan Singh from releasing the report? So before you actually go on the aggressive today, vis-a-vis Mr. Chari, please understand, your one foot is already in quicksand on this issue, Mr. Tiwari.
My dear friend Arnab, may I start off by thanking you for the health warning that my one foot is already in the quicksand. But may I very respectfully remind you that on the 19th of April 2010, in my capacity as a Member of Parliament, I had asked the then Defence Minister the same question as to why the Henderson Brooks report is not being made public. And the answer which I got in writing, which is available on the website of the PRS, you know, essentially said that it is top secret, and because there are operational reasons, therefore the Henderson Brooks report cannot be made public. Now, after that, you had excerpts of that alleged report being printed in a newspaper, and you had the Bharatiya Janata Party going hammer and tongs, saying that the report should be put into the public domain. Now, this is an institutional question that after 52 years of the 1962 conflict, are we as a nation mature enough to handle whatever conclusions Henderson Brooks may have come to or not? I'm sure that nobody would dispute the fact that in 52 years, the strategic landscape has changed. You know, the border situation has changed. So therefore, I cannot countenance as to how something which was relevant in 1962 strategically is relevant in 2014. And in fact, if you look around the world, most countries, after a gap of 30 or 40 years, do declassify documents. So therefore, it's not a question of joining issues with Mr. Seshadri Chari or with Mr. Arun Jaitley. I think it's a larger institutional question as to how do we deal with documents, you know, which have historical value.
No, don't broad-base the issue.
Time frame
no,
when
no,
they
this
need
is,
to be
no, no,
put
no,
out
I
in
find,
the public
I find
domain.
This is, there is a very,
and
there is a very
and
ominous
and
attempt
should,
that both of you are,
should,
no, there's an ominous thing that you are doing.
To deal with them in that context, you know, rather than making it a political football. I think that's the germane question.
Mr. Tiwari, there is no need to make it political football, because what is going on is a simple case of factual football. You did not make the report public for 52 years. Why didn't you? Is it because you were hesitant to reveal the extent of failure of Jawaharlal Nehru vis-a-vis the decisions that were made in the run-up to and during the war? How do I believe?
Well,
was it because you are embarrassed about the failure of your Congress Party political leadership at that time?
That's an unwarranted conjecture, Mr. Goswami.
How is it unwarranted, sir?
How is it unwarranted? You do not know allegedly
what is written
in the report.
And did you question AK Antony when he told you that this was an extremely sensitive document of operational value which he cannot disclose to you in his reply to you in 2010? No, sir, Mr. Tiwari, the fact of the matter is you said nothing, you kept quiet. You raised the issue,
Goswami, but you kept quiet. If you finished with your question or your diatribe, would you allow me to respond to that? What I had tabled was a parliament question. I do not decide whether it becomes a starred question or an unstarred question. If it would have been a starred question where you could ask supplementaries, of course I would have asked the defense minister on the floor of the house as to why is he given a reply in a particular manner. But
so that's what are you all
issue.
Hiding?
The question is,
what are you all hiding?
How do we intend dealing with documents which have historical value? And this conclusion that you've come to, that the document contains inferences with regard to the former Prime Minister of India, I do not know how do you come to those conclusions. Have you seen the document? Have you read the document? You know, all that is there are certain alleged purported leaks of that document which were published in a newspaper. So that's
sir, don't run
what
it
I'm
down.
Trying to
don't,
say.
No, don't
rather
run it
than
down.
Conjecturing and rather than insinuating,
sir,
why,
I am not conjecturing.
Why don't we as a country, and this is not about the BJP and the Congress, why
sir,
don't we as a country
this is about,
take a policy view with
sir,
regard to historical documents and say that, look,
sir, this is not about historical documents alone. This is about the reality of the 1962 war. And dare I say today, it appears to be a political conspiracy between the Congress and the BJP. you know, both to argue on behalf of each other to deny access to a document that is 52 years old. Maruf and GD Bakshi, I'd like to get you into this debate. Maruf, to you first. You know, this Manish Tiwari is trying to obfuscate the matter, Maruf. He says it's an issue of how we should look at declassified documents. No.
Yes.
I want to know about what went wrong in the 1962 war. And Manish Tiwari should know that war after war and conflict after conflict in country after country, if from the Falklands War to the all the wars in which the US was engaged, to the Crimean War and how Britain defeated Russia, everything was made public in a few years. It's not like their strategic interests were ever damaged. No, one second, Maruf Raza, what are the politicians trying to do here?
Therefore, Arnab, before you go to Maru obfuscate the issue, that's exactly the point which I've been pleading all these years.
So then what are you hiding?
Why don't you take a policy call and after a certain number of years, set a cutoff, 3 decades, 4 decades, whatever you think, goes beyond the threshold of your operational readiness, and after that put the documents out in the public domain. So where is the obfuscation?
Sir, the obfuscation is that it has been 52 years since the 1962 war. It is baffling that Arun Jaitley in his written reply to the Rajya Sabha is echoing what Defence Minister YB Jawan said in 1963. So, Nehru said there will be a comprehensive inquiry in 1962. What is the purpose of an inquiry if its findings remain hidden indefinitely over 3 generations? Now let me get Maruf in.
So therefore, you should ask this question to the current defence minister or his predecessor.
Mr. Tiwari,
I cannot be held responsible for what was said in 1963 because I was born in 1965 only.
No, because your argument, Mr. Tiwari, is very convenient Mr. for Seshadri Chari.
You have given
Seshadri Chari an escape route.
No.
Seshadri Chari, therefore, what's it? Seshadri Chari now, Maruf.
It's not political football.
Seshadri Chari can say one thing before the election and one thing after the election and say, I got access to facts.
It's not. It's a fact.
Demanding that the Henderson Brooks report should be made public, insinuated about various things. Now they are in a position to be able to do that. So therefore, not only the Henderson Brooks report, let them take a policy call, involving all the stakeholders with regard to what is the threshold limit for putting, confidential or secret documents out in the
public domain. I don't buy this at all, sir, because the Kargil Review Committee, certain parts of the Kargil Review Committee have been made public, submitted on 15 December 1999.
Certain parts, not the entire report. And certain parts of this report is also in the public domain.
Sir,
that is what I'm saying.
Not officially.
I fully agree with the difference between being in the public domain against the government's will and the difference between declassified. I agree with Manish Tiwari on this one thing.
Let us have a broad-based discussion on what is the threshold limit for putting
out the book.
Of course, you'll agree with him
because it will not, because now you don't have to answer using that argument.
No, I agree with him because he makes a logical point. I may not agree with him on all the points, but on this one point,
sir,
he is making a logical conclusion
fine, so
of it.
Fine.
So to that extent, I agree. What is wrong if we agree on a logical point?
What is wrong is the basic question today, Mr. Chari, is your stand now saying we will not reveal the report completely proves one thing, that you were in the run-up to the election opposing sake. 1 minute.
Huh.
Your tall claims of seeking total transparency, full disclosure on strategic issues, taking the people of this country into confidence, etc., has all been proven wrong. And I'd like to remind you, and I want Maruf Razai on the debate, this is the second time that the Bharatiya Janata Party, this is the second time that the BJP has prevented the public disclosure of the Henderson Books.
We are still committed to that, but we cannot do anything that will endanger the national security of this country. We cannot do that, period.
Then tell me why Rajnath Singh during the 50th anniversary of the 1962 war said the people of India have a right to know why the government could not protect India's pride and national interest.
Yes.
Why did he say the BJP BJP demands that the books Bhagat committee report should immediately be
declassified. Yes, we still want to know that. We still want to know that.
You want to know that,
but what report to be made complete?
Sir, you're mocking a mockery.
What is to be made public and what is not to be made public is what is to be debated and decided.
Well, if it was to be debated, why did you make it an election?
We are against.
Did you make it an election issue?
We did not make it an election issue. We wanted to raise this issue.
No, sir, you made it an election issue.
And the defense minister at that time gave an explanation. We took that explanation, but after that we have not made it an election issue.
Sir, you made it an
election issue. As far as the failures of the prime minister at that time, 1962, is concerned,
Maruf and
it
GD
is all in the public domain.
Okay, gentlemen, Maruf Raza's turn and then GD Bakshi.
I would like
this.
To object to that.
Maruf.
Arnab, one second.
Maruf, Manish Tiwari, one second. Hijacking the debate, I'm going to Maruf next.
You cannot hunt with the hare and hunt with the hound. You know, with regard to the failures of the Prime Minister, the alleged failures, where do you get that from? On one hand, you're not prepared to make the reports of make the report public in contravention of your stand, because now you feel that, you know, it is going to impact national security, and then you insinuate about the role of the former Prime Minister. I mean, that is absolutely not only unfair but completely unethical. As to where do you get that from? Which report says that the former Prime Minister was responsible, you know, for what happened in the 1962 war? Of course, there's collective responsibility of cabinet. Nobody runs away from that. But, you know, to single out a particular person and target him in an unfair manner, I don't think, is either comes from a sense of responsibility or a sense of propriety.
Or take it back.
No.
Take it back. Sir, you want to take it back?
This report, we do not know the contents of this report as of now. But what is more important is there are a number of other reports, also the guilty men of 62 and so many other reports, and those people who were in the theater at that time who have confirmed to all these things, they have taken a collective, in their collective wisdom has said that it was the government of India presided over by the Prime Minister at that time who went wrong in certain decisions.
So that's
and
your guesswork. You're guessing.
It is there. No, there are records. There are
you're
records.
Guessing what's
there are records.
May I remind you, the difference between the Henderson Brooks report and the other accounts is that the other accounts are unofficial accounts. You know, there may be biographies, there may be autobiographies,
yes,
there may be narratives,
okay,
but this
agreed
was an authentic study, commissioned by the Indian Army. So therefore, there is a difference between, you know, those historical narratives and the Henderson.
But Manish, you know, Manish, for God's sake, that is exactly what I'm saying. If this report, Henderson report, is made public, those things which has been said about Mr. Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru will also be confirm, but over and above that confirmation, there will be some other matters, some other issues, some other subjects, some other facts which may not be in our interest today will also come out.
This is
we don't want those things to come out.
But that does not
absolve Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru or the defense minister or the cabinet at that time. That is exactly what we are saying.
This is, and
with all due respects to Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, our first prime minister, let me say, prime ministers can go wrong in decisions.
Vajpayee could have gone wrong.
Yes,
Vajpayee could have gone wrong in the run-up to the Kargil report.
But what is important is, if this Henderson report is made public,
sir,
it will endanger the national security to that extent. We don't want this to be done
sir,
now.
I'm sorry, politician.
If there is a time for this, he can make it later. But not now.
I don't buy this at all.
What the defense minister has said now is not now.
Sir, I don't buy this at all. Politicians release reports, declassify report, put out parts of reports when it is convenient to them.
No, we are not talking
today
of politicians. We are talking of government.
Sir, whatever you are talking as politicians.
We are talking of government.
Sir, there is none of you have been able to explain to the people of this country why there is such a compelling reason to keep this report secret.
That exactly cannot be explained.
Really?
If that is cannot be explained,
really?
It will not be explained.
Really? But the Kargil,
this is not the time to do that.
Really? And it was the time to reveal the Kargil Review Committee report submitted on 15 December, unclassified version of the report with security-based deletions tabled in both Houses of Parliament on 20th February 2000, because you knew when you submitted
that report.
No, because you knew.
That was not the complete
report. Yes, but you knew.
Whatever was to be reported to the Parliament was done.
Sir, you knew that whatever part...
Even now, some parts of the Kargil report is not out.
Be fair to the Indian Army.
No, be fair to the government of India.
Sir, be fair to the Indian Army.
Be fair to the
government of India. The government of India is ultimately responsible for the security.
Be fair to the forces, the people who fight. The Kargil Review Committee report was put out because you knew that by putting parts of it, you can no longer, Vajpayee would have come under criticism for how Vajpayee's actions could have led to a situation where your intelligence, border management and defense management could have had a lax attitude leading to Kargil. One second, sir. I know you're sensitive on Mr. Atal Bihari Vajpayee.
No, it's not the question of sensitivity.
But when you want to give politicians a clean chit, then you put out commissions. When you want to keep the blame on the Indian Army,
you are putting words into me. So I have not said these things. I am not. It's not the question of sensitivity. It's a question of the security. It is a question of security and strategy of this country. The government of India and the defense minister knows best.
Okay, Maruf.
He is under oath.
Now let's go to the army man, please. Maruf, you know, you're telling me your operational strategy. You're telling me operational strategy of 1962, Maruf, according to the gentleman here, could reveal something about a current strategy. I mean, if India's defense strategy is static since 1969, since 1962, then we should all be dead worried, shouldn't we, Maruf? What's the real reason here? What's the politics at work in your view?